God took care of Ruth and Naomi, so I know he'll take care of me and my homie.
Welcome everybody to the Jay Sadie Variety Show, and praise the Lord. Howdy y'all, I'm Jay Sadie Gray. I'm here with my sister Lenny. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, today we're going to talk about looking on the bright side of things. Another way of putting it, though, is staying positive when hard times come around. You know, there's a song that reminds me of that attitude, and we would sing it when we were in grade school, Lenny and I, and our music teacher, Miss Geyser, taught it to us. And every now and then, we still burst into song singing it. So thank you, Mrs. Geyser, for teaching us such a wonderful song and wonderful music. Let's listen to that positive song now. And it was written by Johnny Mercer, and it's entitled Ac-Cent-Tchu-Ate The Positive, sung by Perry Como.
Ac-Cent-Tchu-Ate the positive, eliminate the negative. Ac-Cent-Tchu-Ate the positive, and latch on.
You gotta accentuate the positive, eliminate. Eliminate the negative and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum and have faith.
Amen.
A pandemonium liable to walk upon the scene.
Amen.
To illustrate my last remark, Jonah in the way, Noah in the ark. What did they do?
What did they do?
Just when everything looks so dark.
What do they, what do they, what do they do?
Man, they said you better accentuate the positive. Eliminate the negative and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't you mess with Mr. In Between.
To illustrate his last remark.
What do they do?
What do they do just when everything looks so dark? What do they do? What do they do?
Man, they said you gotta accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't you mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
Such an uplifting song. You know, in the book of Philippians, in chapter 4 and verse 8, in the Holy Bible, we find that Apostle Paul writing a letter to the church in Philippi, and he was writing it in part to encourage them and to help them to stay unified. Then, at the end of the book, he tells them to keep positive thoughts, saying, "Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things." Wow, that verse would be good to cross-stitch and use as a wall hanging. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
And reading in the book of Ruth, we find Naomi complaining about her circumstances and having a little bit of a pity party for herself, even changing her name to Mara, which means bitter. Ruth, however, stayed right with her and kept a positive attitude. And, you know, it eventually rubbed off on Naomi. And in chapter 4, verse 14, it tells us that the women in the town told Naomi she should bless the Lord for giving her a nearer kinsman redeemer in the baby son of Ruth. His name was Obed. And the Bible says he will be unto her a restorer of her life and a nourisher of her old age. For your daughter-in-law, who loves you, which is better to you than seven sons, has borne him. Isn't that wonderful? When we stop focusing on the negative and begin to focus on what God gives us, like Naomi did with Ruth, God will bless us through what He has given us to focus on. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, it's time for another song. Here is Fernando Ortega singing, "Let the Words of My Mouth Be Pleasing to You."
Let the words of my mouth be pleasing to you, pleasing to you. The meditation of my heart be pleasing to you. Pleasing to you, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Of my heart be pleasing to you, pleasing to you. Oh Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Oh Lord, my strength. Whatever is true, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is worthy, think on these things. These things. Let the words of my mouth be pleasing to you, pleasing to you.
Terrific song by Fernando Ortega. So, keeping with being positive theme, there's an old adage that says, life is like a bowl of cherries, meaning everything's going to go well or everything is good. So we thought we'd share some tips to keep in mind about cherries and when they're good and in season. For something different, just coarsely chop up some sweet cherries and add them to the frosting, and especially chocolate frosting. Then just frost your cake. It is awesome. And another idea is, when possible, pick your cherries with the stem on. They'll keep longer, and that'll give you more time to get them canned or to freeze them or even to eat them. Well, getting back to thinking on the good things, you know it's easier to do when you have Christ in your life. And through Him, the Holy Spirit will help you to focus on what is good and what is lovely. And if you want Jesus in your life, just pray this prayer with me. Say, "Dear Jesus, I need you in my life. I acknowledge that I have sinned, and I confess that to you and ask forgiveness. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins, and I believe you are the Son of God, and that you rose from the dead and are alive today. I receive you as my Savior and Lord. Please make me the kind of person you want me to be and control my life from now on. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen." Well, if you prayed that prayer and you believe it in your heart, you just got saved. Call somebody and tell them the good news. And write us today. Let us know if you made that decision. And maybe you might even have a prayer request, a question, or a comment. And you can reach us here at the station or just email us at contact@jsadiegray.com, or you can like us on Facebook at j.sadiegray. You can purchase our books online if you want, barnesandnoble.com, amazon.com, and they're also available over in Maryville at Hastings, in Jellicoe at the Jellicoe Family Museum, in Clinton at the Hoskins Drug Store, and in La Follette at Gifts from Above. And just a reminder, our radio shows also being archived on GodTube. Just search for j.sadiegray, all small letters and no spaces. And thanks for listening to us, and we hope we were a blessing to you today on today's program. And we've got time for another song, and we're going to leave you with it now by the group I Worship, singing "Think on These Things."
Whatever is true, whatever is right, whatever is honorable, we are to think upon these things. Yeah, whatever is true, whatever is right, whatever is honorable, we are to think upon these things. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross for all our shame. Christ is our example of how to live our lives each day. So read about him in his word and trust him and obey. Whatever is true, whatever is right, whatever is honorable, we are to think upon these things. Yeah, whatever is true, whatever is right, whatever is honorable, we are to think upon these things. His workmanship created in Christ Jesus for good works that he's prepared in advance for us. He's expressed this in his word. So be imitators of our God as children dearly loved. You were once in darkness, now you're light to him. So set your mind on things above. Oh, forgetting what's behind, and the time when my soul was dead, pressing forward towards the goal, to win the heavenly prize instead. Whatever is true, whatever is right, whatever.
On behalf of Lenny and myself, J. Sadie Gray, let's pray that soon the sun will reign. God bless you all in Jesus' name.